chineke ole kamga esikelegi onyeme uwa o papa ike ligwe ihe oma imere mu au ike inyere mu idrum gana kuko miri ebe ine azum niri chineke
imela 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 o kaka imela chineke imela onyoma
imela 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 o kaka imela chineke imela onyoma
imela imela o kaka imela chineke imela onyoma
imela 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 o kaka imela chineke imela onyoma
like the Spirit, Holy Trinity, the Lord of Gods, the God of Gods, the Holy One.
We thank you for the life in us, the wonderful things you give to us,
the beauty of the truth and the salvation from the cross on which you died to set us free
from all iniquity
and all difficulty, the problems of humanity.
You took it to your destiny, your wonderful Father,
your wonderful Jesus,
and your wonderful Holy Spirit.
Asante, asante, asante,
asante, asante,
asante, asante,
asante,
asante, Baba,
asante,
asante, Mwana,
asante,
asante, Roho,
asante, asante, asante,
webale, webale, webale,
webale, webale,
webale, webale,
webale,
webale, Tata,
webale, webale,
Mwana.
God of God, the Holy One.
We thank you for the life in us, the wonderful.
wonderful things you give to us. The beauty of the truth and the salvation from the cross on which you died to set us free from all iniquity and all difficulty, the problems of humanity. You took into your destiny, your wonderful Father, your wonderful Jesus, and your wonderful Holy Spirit.
Imela, oh kaka, imela
chineke. Yeah, I just and Nakumi Sinzambeka, let Gomi Jorao, Nana Sefele, Photo Bandako Zen, and more deja Bandaka, to see this your fate news to the YouTube Nortala. So, to Gomi Jorao, Nakumi Sinzambe, Nanda Kumi Sinzambe Jorao, for Labandos de la Ro Bandai. 5 years, 10 years, but like a young woman always said, oh, I can't wait for my sister's wedding. So, Nakumi Sinzambe, then Nakumi, and I am so proud of her.
Okay, na famille vous en a ni?
Lazali your sister name. I am
happy. Good.
Yeah,
good,
and I thank God for your valor as well. Mm-hmm. I thank God for your valor. For your valor, he's the best.
Yes.
Other the best. Na kumi sinza mependa. The my sister find the best person.
That's good.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. God
okay,
bless
I'm
you.
Going to get a dress for her.
Okay, thank
right.
you.
Thank you.
When I found you, I found somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate prayer. When I found you, I found what every heart dreams of. When I found you, I found love. When I found you, I found the rest of my life. When I found you, I told all others goodbye. When I found you, I saw my fears fly away like a dove. When I found you, I found love. I know true love sounds crazy, but worth waiting for. You are the one.
nzambe undi misoni meka ya motu ya isi iko e sami
olo
oyaki na bomo inangai.
Began. You've been my dearest friend, and I give you all.
grace you give, I'm blessed abundantly. I can't forget that moment in my life. You made such a change since the Spirit came. I'm not the same, and I want to give you the praise. Whoa.
Mai ai ko sala nzete asara damu na eva mama c'était en ce moment libala e bandaki ne denier mama c'était en ce moment libala e bandaki ne denier. Ezali puya lolendote na libala solo batala kabiza leli banga babo kilo peto sava se meki na yo perdino zala gentil ki si alibala e botosie ah mama perdino zala gentil ki si alibala e botosie.
Donc c'est notre petite soeur. Donc on dit tout le bas qui est tout yé. La petite soeur. Donc tout c'est pensé quoi. Donc on dit qu'il y a tout c'est fait la vie tout c'est fait la vie sonnyosa. Donc moi tout c'est qu'il m'a quitté. Donc tout ça est fort tout. Potozala. Nzamba sungi tokomi. Donc journal Elope, mboule robeta te.
Non,
kanyango jamais na kombo de Yesu au nom de Jésus.
Thank you.
Divina à toi mon chéri, à jamais je serai fidèle, et c'est la vie à tout. surrender. You know what I mean about surrender. We surrender to the Lord, but we also surrender to those whom we love. That you will bless this service. Bless Vernon and Sandra today as they embark on their journey of life together. May God's blessing be upon them. May God's blessing be upon the congregation today. And everything that will be said and done will be said and done for the glory and honor of your name. And all God's people say, amen and amen. Now, at this point, we're going to be blessed with the scripture reading that's going to be read by Sister Lorinda Ector. Let us just support her as she comes.
The first reading is Proverbs chapter 31, reading from verse 10 to 31. And it's a familiar passage of scripture. It's much loved. Proverbs chapter 31, reading from verse 10 to verse 31. The wife of noble character. A wife of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She selects wool and flax and works with eager hands. She's like the merchant ships, bringing her food from afar. She gets up while it is still dark, she provides food for her family and portions for her servant girl. She considers a field and buys it. Out of her earnings, she plants a vineyard. She sets about her work vigorously. Her arms are strong for her tasks. She sees that her trading is profitable and her lamp does not go out at night. In her hand she holds the distaff and grasps the spindle with her fingers. She opens her arms to the poor and extends her hands to the needy. When it snows, she has no fear for her household, for all of them are clothed in scarlet. She makes coverings for her bed. She is clothed in fine linen and purple. Her husband is respected at the city gate when he takes his seat among the elders of the land. She makes linen garments and sells them and supplies the merchant with sashes. She is clothed with strength and dignity and can laugh at the days to come. She speaks with wisdom and faithful instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children arise and come. her blessed, and her husband also, and he praises her. Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her the reward she has earned, and let her works bring her praise at the city gate. The second reading is Ruth chapter 1, verses 15 and 17. Look, said Naomi, your sister-in-law is going back to her people and her gods. Go back with her. But Ruth replied, don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you and me. May the Lord add his blessings to the reading of his word.
Amen. Amen.
I pray that Sandra and Merlin will receive strength and inspiration from the word of God. At this time, I'm going to just hand over for the address to Reverend Clay Luamba. Let us just welcome him back.
Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to take this opportunity to thank I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Chasewood Baptist Church for this wonderful occasion they have given me to be the minister of the day for this special occasion. Your cooperation is highly appreciated, so thank you very much for that. Woman of noble, you can find the wife of good noble character. You can find the wife of noble character. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to give you the topic just before we start. And this is found from where Ruth is wisely responding to her mother-in-law. Nothing will separate me to you. Only death. Now, this is something that I want to share with Sandra and Evelyn as we are seated in this place. Only death can separate you and me. Amen.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful opportunity. Let you empower our lips to bring your word to your people. Let this word, O Lord, bring life and life in abundance. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Only death can separate you and me. This is a very good and a very bold word that Ruth is telling her mother-in-law Naomi. They left their land, Naomi and her husband. They left Bethlehem and they went to Moab, a place where they have no friend, no one to rely on. Suddenly, Naomi is losing her husband. Elimelech has died, and the two sons they had have passed away. She has stayed on her own as a widow, mother of no one. Fortunately, she had two daughters-in-law. And the two ladies, when Naomi says, God has treated me with bitterness. I cannot do anything now. I need to go back to Bethlehem to my people. You young ladies, you too young. You're too young. Even if I can have children now a day, or now and now on, it's impossible for them to grow and marry you. Therefore, go back to your families. Sometimes life brings us things where you cannot expect. Disaster can come in your life. Difficulties can come in your life. Times can be very, very, very tough, up to the point that somebody would say, the Lord has treated me with bitterness, has treated me badly. Naomi chose even to change her name, not to call herself Naomi. She said, my name is Mara. Mara in Hebrew means bitterness. Is somebody here?
Amen.
My life is bad, ruined. There's nothing I can do for you, my daughters-in-law. Let me tell somebody, when you think everything is gone, you can do nothing, the Lord is telling you, you can still do something.
Amen.
When you think everything is gone and no hope, life becomes very bad. The Lord said, trust me.
Mm-hmm.
I can make every single thing new for you.
Amen.
Am I talking to someone today?
Yes.
Your friend can go. They can leave you. You can stay in a situation where no one can trust you, no one can come to commiserate you, everybody is running away from you.
Amen.
Even if you have nothing,
uh-huh,
hold on to the Lord.
Amen.
Even if you have nothing today,
amen,
the Lord can do more than what you can imagine.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then one of the daughters-in-law said, I'm going. Bye-bye, Naomi. There will be time people will not be patient with you. They will leave you and they will go. But yet I thank God because there will still be someone who will be faithful, holding on to you, staying with you, even if time become very bad. They will be there. Naomi said, I cannot leave you. I love this. It's very much romantic. That's why I wanted to share this scripture with you. I will be with you all the time. Your people will be my people.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes when we are in a marriage situation, we think our home is only for us. I love my man, I don't love my man's people. I love my wife, I don't love my wife's people. That's not interesting. Because before I met my wife, I believe she came from a family. Oh, am I talking to someone?
Oh, yes.
There have been people who cannot sleep at night because of my wife's illness. There were people who sacrificed their money because they wanted to invest in my wife's life.
Mm-hmm.
And likewise, myself, I have a family. It means for my wife to enjoy a very good husband. It means I am a product of an investment.
Yeah.
Somebody invested in my life. So when I get married, I don't get those people aside. They are important. They must be invited. Oh my God, am I talking to someone?
Yes.
They are equally important. As we are enjoying our marriage life, we need to value our families as well. I don't believe in a society where people are becoming individualistic. It's only me and my husband. No! It's only me and my wife. No! My family members, your wife's family members, are equally important. That's why Naomi wisely said, your people will be my people. Am I talking to someone?
Oh, yes. Yes.
If they come to visit us, I want them to be surrounded with joy and happiness in my house. To say, oh, we thank God because our son has got not only a beautiful wife, but she has a wife of noble character. Let them come and enjoy time in your house. And when the family of the lady comes, let them say, oh, our daughter has not only had a handsome man, but he has a very responsible man, a good man for us. You will make your home a home of blessing, a home of happiness. A home where everyone, when they come in the house, they feel looked after and they feel valued. Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
Only death can separate you and me. So for you to succeed in your marriage, Val and Sandra, let me tell you right now, from the oracle of the Lord, for you to succeed in your marriage, a marriage is like a house you're building. You need a strong foundation.
Yeah.
No matter how beautiful is the house, but if the foundation is not as solid as possible, your house will crumble when the storm comes.
Yeah.
That's why you need Jesus, the rock of ages, the strong foundation. He can strengthen you when everybody runs away from you. It will be there. Am I talking to someone? It will be there. And it will never let you down, and it will never forsake you.
Amen.
So now when you have Jesus, I want you to say, let your marriage be Christ-centered. Let Christ live in your marriage. Let you reflect the love of Christ in your marriage. And that if Christ is the rock of ages in your marriage, love will be there. You wouldn't force your husband to say, love me. She will love you because Christ would have taught him to love you.
Amen.
Amen. You will never tell your wife, respect me. She will respect you because Jesus will be there telling him or telling her to respect you all the time. That's the first thing you need. Love. The second thing that you would like to have is forgiveness. Many marriages are splitting apart because people think they will get a partner who's perfect. I've been in the ministry for more than 15 years. I've never seen a perfect woman. I've never seen a perfect man.
Yes.
I don't know if there's one man who's perfect in this hall here. I don't believe that. We all have our strengths and weaknesses.
Yes.
Yet we learn to support each other.
Yes.
That's what will make your marriage very strong. Be able to forgive your partner if something bad happens. The third thing I want to share with you quickly is mutual appreciation. Learn to appreciate your partner.
Yes.
Even in the very little things she's doing or he's doing for you, learn to appreciate. Unfortunately, some people are very mean up to the point that they can't even not appreciate. Even if you do all you can do, they cannot appreciate. What am I getting in this house? Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's important for you to learn to appreciate. Appreciation will make your partner feel loved, feel lifted up, and then you will be, or he or she will be able to continue to give more and more and more, to do more and more and more for the blessing of your marriage. Maybe there is a woman here crying, they never appreciate me, even if I take my time to prepare a very good sauce. They don't appreciate it. Take time to look for hairs in the soup. Oh, what is this? It's just salty today. But what is really delicious? You don't appreciate. Why do you just take time to criticize rather than taking time to see what is good?
Amen.
Learn good things today. And the Lord will bless your marriage.
Amen.
Transparency, very important. Be transparent from one another to one another. Because you become one. Becoming one, it means you cannot hide anything from yourself. Be able to be transparent. Amen.
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 A lady was washing her husband's clothes and then she found some Western Union papers behind her, did some transaction to his family without the wife knowing. What kind of marriage are you going to be? That's very dangerous because you're giving a very wrong signal to your partner. If you can lie to me, or if you are not open to me, it means you are continuously not telling me the truth. Learn to be transparent. If you have nothing, say I have nothing. Maybe you have something, please be open and say I have something. At least your marriage will continue to be a very good place. Listening skills. You're getting married. I married my wife today. I think it's roughly 17 years since we are together. I've never been able to give her a... Are you with me? I've never been able to smack her because I can't smite myself. I've never been able to do that. Learn to respect each other in your marriage. Listening skill is very important. When you get married, doesn't mean you will have about the same education, not necessarily. Someone might not really be very well educated at the school point of view, but they have the divine understanding of things.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Amen.
They can tell you things which can be profitable for your couple. Sometimes we do neglect each other in our marriages. Pay more attention, develop listening skills. If you want to do something your partner is preventing you from doing, ask yourself twice. Why is she refusing? Did you do that? Don't just say, I am acting as a man. My house, my room. It's no longer your house, it's our house.
Yes.
Oh my God, am I talking to someone? It's no longer your house, it's our house. Basically, this is to say our house, our rules. Today you need to be able to talk. That's why I'm bringing you to dialogue. Be able to talk to each other. Discuss your plan before you act. This will make you a very strong family. And you will progress with the Lord. Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Treat your partner as you would love to be treated. Amen. Velen treat Sandra the way you would love to be treated. And Sandra treat Velen the way you would love to be treated. If this is the way you can do, your marriage will be a blessing. And you will be an inspirational couple for many, many people around you. Amen.
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 Make your house a home for both of you, your family, your children, and your loved ones. A home, I love this from English people, a home is a place where your heart is. Wherever you go, even if you can be in your business, let you be more than happy in your house. And make your house a home for both of you, your children, your visitors, and your loved ones. Whenever people come to see you, let them be happy. Because they know that we are going to a couple which has maturity. And they know how they can treat people, and they know how they can deal with people when they come on their doorstep. Somebody can say amen.
Amen.
Somebody can say amen.
Amen.
Finally, I want to conclude. And I told Brother Jeremy I'm going to be reading for 20 minutes, but I think it's about the 15 minutes or something. Let me conclude and give 5 minutes for the sermon to continue. There was a man. That man was a very, 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 very blessed man. Actually, he was the director of a company. And he wouldn't leave Africa to come to Belgium to represent the business. And he was a man full of money, full of new cars that no one has ever driven, packed outside his house. Very, very wealthy. Now this man had a problem with his wife, and he decided not to talk to his wife. And when they are sleeping in their bed, they take the blanket, they put between them two. When we sleep at night, don't cross on my side. Stay where you are. And when they come to the church, a very good church member, when they come to the church, hallelujah.
Amen.
What would happen is, they come together, ladies talk sometimes very much with their friends, yeah? When they keep talking, the husband is gone, you start the car up. You cannot call the woman, his wife. He's waiting. When she's coming. And then they come to the car, the lady comes in, then they go. The church was finding them to be a very good couple. But in reality, the couple marriage was rotten inside. There are many people can give you the very outside, very good appearance. But the house is burning. Don't let it be burnt until you can save nothing. This is the time for you to bring Christ in your marriage. He will restore your marriage, no matter the situation is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What happened? Now they started to communicate through letters. They live in the same house under the same roof, but they don't talk to each other. They do write to each other instead. When the husband has a program, he would write a piece of on a piece of paper. He leaves somewhere there. The wife knows when I come back. This is what I'm going to collect. Oh, this is the message. She replies and she lives there. That's the way they were living, and it was on and on and on. The husband had a special mission to come to Belgium or to go to Belgium to represent his business. Listen, you who's listening to me now, you can save your marriage. It's not only about Melvin and Sandra, it's also about you and about me.
Amen.
So the husband came, the company got a lot of money for him to travel and represent the country, his company. Then at night, he wrote a letter, left it, and said to his wife, "Please wake me up at 4 o'clock. Because I'm traveling to Belgium." Then the wife at 4 o'clock woke up as a very, very good woman. She could not wake him up because we can't talk to each other. She wrote a letter, "Wake up." Some people, when they sleep, they snore. The wife goes to the kitchen, comes back. "Oh, are you still sleeping? Wake up! The 20 past 4. She leaves the letter there. The man continued to sleep. Up to around 7 o'clock, he woke up. When he woke up, the plane was already gone. As you know, the plane wouldn't wait for you. You need to go and wait for the plane. And then what happened? He went to the airport. It was late. The meeting took place. But when he came back, "Why didn't you wake me up? Hey, don't touch me. I didn't wake you up. Go and check the letters." That man, unfortunately, he lost his job. That is from that time that the church knew that there was a problem in their marriage. Sometimes you can give people a very, very good impression outside. Live your marriage in its fullness. We say amen.
Amen.
Don't wait for tomorrow. You can seize this opportunity to make your marriage a beautiful place. A place of joy. A place of blessings. A place of happiness. A place where Christ is to lift it up, most high, and bless you for all the things you can trust in. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, Sandra and Berlin, we wish you all the best, and we believe that the Lord will continue to bless you, and let what Ruth told Naomi and what you're telling to each other, "I will not separate myself from you." It's only death that can separate us. May the Lord bless you in the next
But at this time, we're just going to move into the part where we're going to actually proceed with the marriage at this point. And I believe Sandra's sister, is it Frances? Denise? Yes. Can I have Denise to come forward at this time, please? Let's just support her as she comes. Thank you. I'm just going to ask Berlin to stand as well. And this is the part where we're going to...
Which is an honourable estate, instituted of God.
C'est une institution honorable de Dieu.
And signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church.
Et c'est une signification mystique de l'union qui existe entre Christ et son Église.
This is an holy estate, Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee.
C'est la seule institution de Jésus qui nous a montré cela au départ, à Galilée.
And the Apostle Paul commended as honorable among all men.
Et l'apôtre Paul nous recommande de pouvoir honorer le mariage par tous les hommes.
It is not therefore to be entered into unadvisedly.
Et ce n'est pas intéressant d'y entrer sans avoir de bons conseils.
Reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God.
Et on ne peut y entrer sans la révérence, sans le respect et la crainte de Dieu.
I require and charge you both as you stand in the presence of God.
Je vous demande, vous deux, tel que vous êtes devant Dieu,
to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as a foundation of a happy and enduring home.
Vous rappelons que l'amour et la loyauté seuls vous aideront comme étant la fondation d'un mariage heureux dans votre maison.
No other human ties are more tender.
Et il n'y a aucun lien humain.
No other vows more sacred than those you now assume.
Et aucun serment qui soit aussi sacré que celui que vous voulez faire maintenant.
If these solemn vows be faithfully kept.
Si cet engagement est respecté fidèlement.
And if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your heavenly Father.
Et vous donnant la possibilité de vous lever pour faire la volonté de votre Père céleste.
Your life will be full of joy.
Votre vie sera pleine de joie.
And your home you are establishing will abide in peace.
Et votre maison demeurera en paix.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Qui donne cette femme pour qu'elle soit mariée par cet homme? It's me.
Madame
Denise.
Je suis la sœur de Sandra.
It's me, Madame Denise. I am Sandra's sister.
Thank you.
Merci.
Together.
Pour que leur vie soit ensemble.
And and be nurtured in their love for God.
Et qu'ils soient entourés et qu'ils grandissent dans l'amour de Dieu.
God created us male and female.
Dieu nous a créés hommes et femmes.
And gives us marriage so that husband and wife.
Et il nous a donné le mariage pour que le mari et la femme
may help and comfort each other.
S'aident mutuellement et se confortent mutuellement également.
Living faithfully together in need and in plenty.
Qu'ils vivent ensemble et qu'ils grandissent ensemble dans l'abondance.
In sorrow and in joy.
Pendant le moment de malheur et pendant le moment de joie.
In sickness and in health.
Pendant les moments de maladie et pendant les moments de bonne santé.
Throughout all their days.
Durant toute leur vie.
God gives us marriage for the full expression of love.
Dieu nous a donné le mariage pour l'expression pleine de son amour.
Between a man and a woman.
Entre un homme et une femme.
In marriage, a woman and a man belongs to each other.
Dans le mariage, la femme et l'homme s'appartiennent mutuellement.
And with affection and tenderness.
Avec l'affection et la tendresse.
Freely give themselves to each other.
Et ils se donnent mutuellement, librement.
God gives us marriage for the well-being of the human society.
Dieu nous donne le mariage pour le bien-être de la société humaine.
For the ordering of family life.
Pour la continuité de la vie familiale.
And for the birth and nurture of children.
Pour la naissance et la croissance des enfants.
If either of you know any reason why you may not be lawfully married, you should say so now.
Si Berlin, tu sais qu'il y a quelque chose qui t'empêchera de te marier légalement, tu dois devoir me la déclarer maintenant.
I declare that I know of no legal reason why I, Verlin Manasso, may not be joined in marriage to Sandra Manobo.
Je déclare qu'il n'y a aucune raison légale pouvant m'empêcher, moi, Verlin Manasso, de me marier légalement avec Sandra.
I declare there's not any reason that will stop us me and Sandra getting married.
Je ne crois qu'il n'y a aucune raison légale m'empêchant de me marier avec Sandra.
Est-ce que tu la réconforteras? Est-ce que tu seras
à lui.
As long as you both shall live.
Aussi longtemps que vous voulez, vous allez vivre, vous continuerez à vivre.
Hey!
name, we just appreciate you. We love you and we bless you and we lift you up. God, because the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies, they never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. By your blessing, may these rings be to Vernon Malasso and Sandra Malobo, symbols of the vow they have made this day and of the covenant into which they have entered. By your grace, help them to be faithful to each other in unbroken love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Ring of the spoil.